Is it live? Did it work? Hopefully it worked. Waiting the 10 seconds, but I got a song queued up here. It's got roughly a 10 second intro. It's probably longer, but whatever. For the sake of the joke, 10 seconds. Let's do this. If you know this one, sing along. I'll have no idea whether you did or not. But that's okay. This is hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids, not even that dirty. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids, not even that dirty. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids, not even that dirty. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids. You can understand every single word I say. I slowed it down. White people like it that way. Don't mess around. Keep it all PG. It's all above the belt. You know it's all PC. LGBT. I mind my P's and Q's, cause what you do doesn't matter to me. Just do you. And don't bother anybody who's not you. See? It's easy. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids, not even that dirty. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids, it's not even that dirty. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids, it's not even that dirty. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids, not even that dirty. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids, not even that dirty. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids. White people like songs about love and boats that offer solutions and give hope. White people like guys that sound like Eminem, might listen to any cheap imitation of him. White people like self-deprecating humor, and when Arnold Schwarzenegger says it's not a tumor. White people like going to see remakes of movies that were trash when they came out in the first place. Hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids, not even that dirty. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids, it's not even that dirty. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids, it's not even that dirty. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids. White people own more than one scarf. White people own an umbrella that doesn't work. White people can never get on the Wi-Fi. They never have a lighter and look ugly when they cry. White people like Adele and Lizzo. They don't realize Baby Yoda is Gizmo. White people take one picture and then one that's silly. It's not the heat that gets you, it's the humidity. Not getting far without these. They say while they jingle forgotten keys, box of Triscuits, we LaBrie cheese. Hit the Mandarin birthday party. Only white people polish their skis and hit the closest beach at 17 degrees. White people enjoy songs like this, which is good, cause they're the reason it exists. This is hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids, it's not even that dirty. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids, it's not even that dirty. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids, it's not even that dirty. It's hip-hop for white people over 30. Listen with your kids. You could listen with your kids. You could listen with your kids. Cause it's not even that dirty. That song's for white people. And I definitely got a little sloppy with the timing there. That's okay. I'll point out my mustard stain. We know that. There was a show just called Mustard Stain that's posted on YouTube. You should go check it out. Because, yeah. DJ Aram is here. Yo, he caught those mistakes. He's shaking his head. He's like, it's off. It's no good. But, friends, that's okay. It's a throwaway to start us off. Make sure the levels are okay. How does everything sound, Shane? Is it reasonably close? Is it a complete disaster? Somebody let me know. I'm out here on an island. But I'm here. We're here. I'm here because I'm going to turn this video into
my 500th YouTube video. And I figured, you know, I've hit some of those milestones and made a big deal about it. Maybe a bigger deal than it needed to be. I don't know. I don't know the etiquette where I'm stumbling through. So here we are, 500 videos. And I'm going to give it one of these. Because that's exciting. 500 videos. And so as to not ramble, I'm going to pick another song to sing. And I think it's going to be this one. This song's called Kingpin. Not regular man, I rap on everything. I rap the blank while I wait for the light to change. I'm not regular man, I rap on everything. I rap the blank while I wait for the light to change. Oh, I'm not normal. No shitting, it's mesmerizing. The time I spend memorizing and spinning, rearranging syllables to instill a pulse like a heartbeat hidden beneath the retreating. Timidly meek gimmick image, I compete within a world that just keeps on spinning. Human zoo, you come and tap on the glass, or you can rattle my cage, or you can kiss my ass. Call me Kingpin, Wilson Frisky, writing lyrics while I'm drinking Fireball whiskey. Yeah, that's so cinnamon. He got a Mickey in my pocket like I'm trying to be tricky. Call me Kingpin, Wilson Frisky, writing lyrics. What, what's happened? Where did my volume go? Ladies and gentlemen. Uh-oh. Now we got problems. Okay, hold on here. Better. Well, I'm just gonna stop that. My mom is here. Sip, sip. Yes. I don't know what's happened to the audio there, so I'm gonna run it through the. That was me opening a beer, so that I can sip, sip, everybody. Maybe we'll even do a hard reset. I can cut this out of the YouTube version. That's the beauty. My Facebook friends are my friends. They know we make mistakes. They don't care. So, hopefully, you can hear music. I don't know. I'm gonna hope you can hear the music, friends. And we'll just start again. I'm not regular man, I rap on everything. Well, friends, here we are. I don't know if you guys can hear the music or not. Maybe I'm gonna try and plug that thing back in. That's good, right? That's a good sign. You want that, right? Oh my god. Okay, let's try another one. Okay, now it sounds like we got some volume. Let's see what happens. This is called Bard Song. And I'll tell you the tale about a man and a time that did not mix so well. You know that man is me and the time is now. So sit back and listen, here's how it went down. No, maybe just quick you could help me out here and snap a bit to create atmosphere like da 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 da. Yes, I'll commence with an introduction, because that might be the perfect place to begin. You see, I'm POE and I think I'm living in an era I'm not supposed to be in. See, There was a time and I think I was robbed. I could sing for the king, and that was my job. I'd regale him with stories of battle and gods, and tell him the tale of a time come and gone. Got a tanker to bail and a mug full of mead. You find me up on the tabletop and stomping my feet, and everybody is enthralled by me while I perfectly tell the collective story. But nowadays, oh, everything's changed. It's hard for a storyteller to get paid. Oh, what with the web and YouTube and MySpace and special books designed for my face. There's no doubt in my mind that my time's been replaced by the internet and skyscraping landscapes. But maybe one day they'll tell of a man who sang a bard song at poetry slam. Maybe one day they'll tell of a man who sang a bard song at a poetry slam. Yeah, maybe one day they'll tell of a man who sang a bard song at a poetry slam. We all snapped along, we all clapped our hands, and when it was over, up came the tans, and we begged him for more till he did an encore. He just sang the same story louder than before. So we all bought a book, came with a CD, and that paid for his tanker to bathe in his weed. And that's how one day they'll tell of a man who sang a bard song at a poetry slam. Yeah, that's how one day they'll tell of a man who sang a bard song at a poetry slam. Yeah, that's how one day they'll tell of a man who sang a bard song at a poetry slam. And we all snapped along, we all clapped our hands, and when it was over, up came the tans, and we begged him for more till he did an encore. He just sang the same story louder than before. So we all bought a book, came with a CD, and that paid for his tanker to fill in his weed. And that's how one day to tell of a man who sang a bard song at a poetry slam. That one day they'll tell of a man who sang a bard song at a poetry slam. That one day they'll tell of a man who sang a bard song at a poetry slam. Yeah, that one day they'll tell of a man who sang a bard song at a poetry slam.
True story. A true, true story. I'm on it this time after having done enough of these Facebook live shows to know that I need to manually stop the iTunes, or it's just going to roll it on over into the next track. And I can't have that because I'm not ready. I'm also getting pretty good at turning off the vocal processor in between tracks. I want to toot my own horn, but let's check out what's happening over here. Check your plugins, working great now. Okay, well, hopefully it's okay. And everybody can hear the things. And what I may do is, if you already did watch the start of the video, pretend you didn't. I'll just come in here and be like, my 500th YouTube video, we'll put some stuff back here, you know? Doing it on the green screen so I can be wherever I want. I might do a show up on top of a mountain. I might be deep, deep in the sea. Who knows? I might put myself on the Me and the Boys background. Why not? Friends, these Me and the Boys shirts are available. They're $20. We have them in all sizes if that's something that interests you. Who else is excited for tomorrow's episode, Me and the Boys Wrestling? We are inching closer and closer to next week's Bay Clash. Cheers, everybody. I lean that way, I get feedback. Let's see what else we got here. There it is. A DJ Aram original.
I always know the best way to say it, so I'ma spray it in a way that's adjacent to amazement and slay it. Not just okay it, KO it.
So you wanna replay it, you wanna rip it, spread it up and download it to repay it. When I spit the script, articulate, you know what I am saying, like it's racquetball. And you're playing an Olympic champion without a racket in your hand. And these words are coming at you, you don't understand. You don't even have enough common sense to pay attention. Inspection, detecting perfection from divine intervention. Listen, it's a mission and it's come to fruition. So brothers and sisters, begin ignition. This is last call before blast off. So hop aboard before you get passed on. Don't get passed on. Nothing that I knew was true and nothing's what it seems. Why's everybody's middle finger linger over me? It's like a riddle, no solution. I can't find the answer key. It's like a collar, but get ready, cause I'm about to break my leash. Think I got no teeth to bite a beat with my ability. When I eat and sleep and speak and spit, air at my own futility. Now it's a battle. Me against diplomacy, and that's why my enemies are extra close to me. I try to strike first like my kind. What in the hell? God, that is so frustrating, friends. Okay. And so is that high-pitched noise. Like, is this gonna do this every 3 to 5 minutes, or every time I'm just in the middle of a song? The chord does feel loose, though. Wow. It's not good. What do you do now, you know, from a live performance standpoint? This is a genuine challenge of improv skills. Let's try this one. And if it goes sideways, I don't know. Let's see what happens here, though. This is my theme song, a DJ Aram original. There's some kind of a blur in the line. It's absurd, like where is the respect that I feel that I deserve? Just for making these words and these sentences work. With clever strawberry goo in the middle, like that big turd can't unravel my metaphors. My words instead of yours, irritating by the black heads in your pores. Can't deny what I create with this language. It's visual images of emotional baggage, and it's beautiful. But it's designed to ruin you and make you sick, and that's his job. I'm not trying to fool you like I'm the scab you just picked off. Now I'll leave a scar. I'm the guy you just kicked off that wrote the song, but how you are. I'm the guy that says gross shit with no filter. Like they should lock up my tongue with the rest of the silver. I'm just some weirdo whose axis is off kilter. And this half-ass practice has enough skill to kill you. They said P.I.W.E.Z.E. slow it down a bit. You're just too quick when you spit your shit. And I can't quite catch all the shit you rip. But don't quit like Emmy, you do legitimate. I never understood what that statement meant until I thought long and hard about packing it in. Now fuck that, I'm giving it a whack again. And if you still don't like it, lick my sack again. They call me P.O.E. The poetically organized entity. They call me P.O.E. The poetically organized entity. They call me P.O.E. The poetically organized entity. They call me P.O.E. And I disperse verses with barely any rehearsals and blur curses till her feelings need nurses. Like MCs test me just leaving hearses, cause I'm married to hip hop for better or worse. Finicky misses, makes all my decisions, and this bitch makes me so mad my temperature's risen. And she's the reason for all my hits and misses. And she's vicious when in control of my bodily systems. Makes me write with both hands at once, two-fisted. Got no breath left, but she makes me keep spitting, never listens. Hearing they gives out gifts like Christmas. It pisses me off cause I just don't get this. It's a game to me, I just wait to see if I can trap the negativity inside of me. When I turn the pain into pleasure inside of me, the middle finger's up on the hand that's guiding me. Shining so bright, I'm even blinding me. Got me going into hiding as a finder's fee. You find me right behind you cause I'm kinda creepy. So just remember my initials, I'm the P.O.E. They call me P.O.E. The poetically organized entity. They call me P.O.E.
The poetically organized entity, they call me POE. The poetically organized entity, they call me POE. The poetically organized entity.
Sip, sip. Oh, sip, sip. Cheers, friends. This has been the shakiest start out of one of these yet, but had I not made the mistakes I made in the earlier ones, I feel like I'd be well underprepared to handle a situation like this. 22 minutes in, most of the footage, useless. This is supposed to be the 500th YouTube video. It's a train wreck so far, and not the milestone we were hoping for. But, I mean, we can start fresh at any point. I can just cut it right here. Done. Dunsky. I can be like, oh, check out a word from our sponsor.
DNA. If it's in you,
it should be on you.
Then something will happen and we'll be back. We'll reset it. So I'll just keep doing songs, really. I mean, I don't have a whole lot to say. You should check out our sponsors though, www.420dna.com, because if it's in you, it should be on you, just like it's on me. Hats, t-shirts, hoodies, all sorts of swag, all sorts of different designs and colors. And this man took me to the 420 Expo in Niagara Falls, and we had an absolute blast there, handing out business cards and meeting the people. And I got to meet Business Brent. Business Brent is a different man than regular Brent. This man was laser focused and on point with every conversation he was having. And like, purposeful, you know, everything was done with a plan and a I can't think of the word I'm looking for. Deliberate. Very deliberate. That's what it was. So cheers. It's funny, I'm rattled from the rough start of the video. Rattled is what it is. Worried that whatever the next song is just gonna go out on me mid-song, right at like an awful line or something, but it's okay. The last show I did, I wasn't allowed to perform this one because it has too much swearing, so I'm gonna do it now. Another DJ Aram original. This is called War Song.
Fight. It'd be nice if you relax though. Otherwise, I slice you up precise like an exacto. Can't spell dope without P-O-E. Like dope by midnight demand. See, I got tired of fucking around with wires. I got a mic grafted to my hand. Now I'm commanding respect with this dialect. And then I dry you out just like a diuretic. Like a veteran, gonna keep you up all night and make your head fucking spin when I rock a mic right. These are the physics of words and senses. Like blinking, you'll miss it. That's how quick this kid is. Don't like it, lick shit's what I said. Cause quality reviews in the news are a lot of rent. So believe me when I say that it's not easy being POE. Achieving what I've achieved through the art of poetry. These words are puzzle pieces to me, and every line is the Jesus of my Christianity. And the complete picture is to be giving you the finger. You want more up yours, you're the listener, I'm the singer. Sentences immense, tickle your senses. If you can't see that I'm the best, check your lenses. Pretenses, none destination, fun sense, list eliminated, diagnosis, here I come.
Everything you do,
everything you do,
I do it better than you.
I do it better than you.
Everything you do, I do it better.
I do it better.
Everything you
can
do,
I can do better.
I can do
everything better than you.
Everything you do,
I can do better. I can do everything better than you. It's anarchistic, poetic, linguistic, sadistic, with fatalistic characteristics. Any disrespect I can't simply cause an effect. But being the best at record, fuck before the end of my check. You're all peachy, I'm upper deck. I suspect nine other ones kids want to collect it. I'm guessing it's just not in your cards, babe. Check it, I'll look up exactly what you're worth here in my Beckett. My shit is spicy, text next with hot sauce. Every
everyone sees through you like they got x-ray specs on. And the next day you flip it, switch it, touch you with your decks on. Put a hex on you and a vex on you while I'm delivering rhymes like FedEx on you. When I go T-Rex on you and I'll grab some shit sicker than avian bird flu. It's a crazy and blurred view and the one and only motherfucking video we disturb you.
Everything you do,
everything you do,
I do it better than you.
Do it better than
everything
you.
Everything you do, I do it better.
Everything you do, I can do better. I can do better than you. And you know that's true.
Don't utter a word until the processor's off. I hope you guys can't hear that high pitch. That's going to ruin the video, too. It's like Destiny just wants to ruin this, my 500th video. And that's fine. I'm rolling with it. At this point, I don't know. I've made all the mistakes. Now it's the equipment that's failing. Really? That's nonsense. Friends, I hope you're well. I'm purposefully not looking at the Facebook Live screen. I don't want to see the numbers. I don't want to see my own face. I do have the comment window up, though, in a separate window, so I can see if you comment. And I would love for you to comment. Let me know if it sounds okay or if it's an absolute disaster. Slide this over to here. And let's pick another song. I hope everybody's doing well. Called selective memory. There's a photo album that I'm afraid to see, 'cause the objects in the rear view are closer than they seem. There's a photo album that I'm afraid to see, 'cause the objects in the rear view are closer, closer than they seem. Too early for memoirs, it's too hard to go back. Too tired to fight them wars and trudge that broken glass. Titles in my mind for songs I know I'll never write. Onlookers, move along, 'cause tonight is not the night. There will come a day when I open that car wreck from a million miles away, but I'm not ready yet. How you wade through all that pain and how do you maintain steady and putting pen to page when you write down yesterday? There's a photo album that I'm afraid to see, 'cause the objects in the rear view are closer than they seem. There's a photo album that I'm afraid to see, 'cause the objects in the rear view are closer, closer than they seem. Closer than they seem. Closer than they seem. Closer than they seem. I'm gonna slowly fade it out. Slowly fade it out. I feel like it's gonna cut out on me anyway. Friends, 31 minutes in, and still not a whole lot of usable footage. So, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do a poem, an and try and salvage it. And maybe I'll succeed and maybe I'll fail, but ladies and gentlemen, I have never ever been afraid to fail. I've also never been quite sure how to define success. See, good is phenomenal if you've never heard of great, and I'm too impatient to wait for greatness, so I'm taking it, I'm redefining it, and making it my own greatness. Greatness is stepping on stage with something to say in front of a room full of people waiting to be entertained. Greatness is practicing so much that you live in your poems and they feel like home, and greatness is showing the world how well you know them. Greatness is stepping on stage under the spotlight, knowing if space is infinite in all directions, then right now, I'm at the center of the universe. Greatness is facing and embracing the nerves that would strike you dear and head like dumb. Greatness is bargaining with terror, accepting the terms and conditions of failure, failing, falling flat on your fucking face, getting up fresh to do it all over again tomorrow. Greatness is synonymous with satisfaction as long as you've done the best you can. Even if you do strike out, at least you had a pair of balls when you stepped up to the plate and you swung for the fence instead of just sitting on it. Greatness is keeping time with the tempo of your life, especially when the DJ doesn't play your song. Greatness is funneling your frustration down the throat of anyone who tries to stand in your way. Greatness is breaking down the boundaries you built in your own brain. Greatness is becoming more than you were while remaining who you are. Greatness isn't sacrificing. Greatness is sacrificing. Greatness isn't a goal, it's a statement. So make it. Shout it. Stand up, tell this whole fucking world all about it, and then do it. Do it for all you're worth. Do it so you're better than every idiot who didn't, and be great. Even if you're only great at building memories, build them. Build a mantle for your stories. Treat them like trophies. Use them to measure your success. If you even care. Maybe you were never really looking for success. Maybe what you were looking for was greatness.
More Poe.
I don't even really need a motherfucking beat. People line the streets just to hear me speak. I'm just kidding. That's just me being full of myself. Cheers, friends. Okay, let's try another song and see what happens.
So far, not that great. You with them?
A little bit of corner shop.
It's dancing behind movie scenes, behind those movie screens. Rainy now, Reen. She's the one that keeps the dream alive from the morning past the evening to the end of the line. Oh, it's a brim full of Asher on the 45. It's just a brim full of Asher on the 45. Brim full of Asher on the 45. Oh, it's a brim full of Asher on the 45.
Stop as I drop this bomb. Blow up this place just like another Vietnam. When I'm getting heavy like a Tyson, blow to the dome. Now back up, son, and give me room. When I'ma set it off like this, don't give it up, cause I'm all up in your tear. You just can't get enough, and I'm real hard to the bone. You know you want more when I sneak up on you like a sniper at your back door. It's back flavor for your brain. You know the time. Check my wrath, this is real. I'ma get mine. Roll up on you like Eastwood. I'm blowing up 15. Running through your neighborhood and I'm spreading butter like it's parquet. Real small with the figure, knowing evil when I parlay. Do what you feel, but check the scale, cause I'm in your real life. Beat this, I'm the real deal. In your Jeep Cherokee, I'm a Land Cruiser. When you're rolling through the hood, you wanna use a track like this, all up in your weird drum. So pump the EQ, let the speakers hum.
45, brim full of Asher on the 45. Oh, it's a brim full of Asher on the 45. It's just a brim full of Asher on the 45.
Everybody needs a bosom for a pillow. Everybody needs a bosom. Everybody needs a bosom for a pillow. Everybody needs a bosom on the 45.
Rainy now, Rain. She's the one that keeps the dream alive from the morning past the evening to the end of the line. Oh, it's a brim full of Asher on the 45. It's just a brim full of Asher on the 45. Brim full of
Asher on the 45. It's just a brim full of Asher on the 45. POEZ and the whole damn family mission for a session we had to receive, because it was just a matter of time before our minds collide. So step aside, it's a musical ride. Come and join us in the session, let the bass be your guide. Just close your eyes and let your mind glide and fly. Get lost up in the groove when we do it sicker than avian bird flu. Got a sound that can make you move, put you on the floor to do what you gotta do. Prove what you gotta prove and know that you got nothing to lose. Like, you can come alone and you can bring your crew, but come and join us in the session and get lost in the groove. 45, brim full of Asher on the 45. Oh, it's a brim full of Asher on the 45. It's just a brim full of Asher on the 45. 45, subtle fade out. Yeah, yeah.
Corner Shop Classic from way, way back in the 90s. I hope everybody's well. I hope everybody's out there doing better than I am. If you've been watching or you went back and watched the start, it's a train wreck. Oh my God, I'm gonna have so much editing to do, you guys. It's not even gonna be funny. But that's okay. I'll cut this part right out too, and that'll make it more enticing for you to check it out on YouTube. Because we got the green screen. I'm gonna be up on a mountain screwing up my own songs. You know, I'm gonna be underwater. Well, there's technical difficulties. I'll put myself in a cave, maybe? Who knows? But, definitely, sip, sip. It's nice and sunny outside, but, like, the wind is cold. The sun is fire, but the wind is ice. I don't know what to make of it.
Let's see, what else we got here? Let's do...
I want to live with you in the office so we can play Jim and Pam. I want to work with you at Cheers like Sam and Diane. I want you to be my Lois, my Marge, and my Francine. I want you to be my Rachel, my Monica, and my Phoebe. I've got a theory that I could be your Leonard if you agreed to be my Lucky Penny. I want to love you like soap operas, but I don't fucking know any. I want to love you like they do on TV. I want to love you like they do on movie screens. You had me at hello like Renee Zellweger scenes. Penciled lightly, perfume scented in Bridget Jones's diary. But no fluff and no filler. No psychological thriller. Just straight up Bonnie and Clyde, Mickey and Mallory. A couple of natural born killers. I want to love you like video games and chase you through dungeons and castles just to save you over and over and over again. Your replay value is fantastic. I want to love you like old-time AM radio when I'll even play Margot Lane just to chase your shadow, because who knows what love lurks in the hearts of men. I want to love you to death like Macho Man and Elizabeth or Romeo and Juliet. I want to tame the tiger of love with you on some Siegfried and Roy type shit. I want to love you with the longevity of literature and lore. I want you to be my Lenore. Faintly tapping, gently rapping at my chamber door. Step inside, won't you, from this nice Plutonian shore. And stay with me, quoth P.O.E. Nevertheless, and forevermore. I want you to get abducted just so I can storm the gates of Troy. There is no mission too perilous. To hell and back like Orpheus. Through the lion's jaws like Pyramus. Guinevere doesn't care if King Arthur is aware of this, because she just loves to lance. A lot. I want to love you like pulp pages. Spider-Man and Mary Jane is Superman, and Lois Lane is this bar I've set high for you and I. It's a love for all generations, and we will never be gone with the wind. And frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn what anyone else has to say. I love you, Lucy. You don't have any explaining to do. Benny and June, let me bust my Buster Keaton for you. I want to love you intergalactic like Leia and Luke. Okay, maybe that's a bad one. But I want to love you like pop culture. I want to love you everywhere, all the time, proudly and shamefully, knowing that we might just make a few people jealous enough to change the chin. I want to love you like pop culture.
everywhere and all the time. I want to love you like pop culture. Everywhere and all the time. I want to love you like pop culture. Can't get you off my mind. I can't get you off my mind. I can't get you off my mind. My mind. My mind. I can't get you off my mind. Oh, I can't get you off my mind. My mind. I can't get you off my mind. Oh, 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 oh.
Almost. You tried to roll in on me, I'm not having it. Matty P knows those bars. That was the session. You are correct, sir. I looked at how far the slider was across on that song, and I was like, oh, wow, I'm only halfway. I need more lyrics. And the session, one of my favorites, friend. I hope you're well, sir. It's been a long, long time. My mom wants to hear Mother Nature. We can do that. Jamie Rose misses the bear. Gimmick the bipolar bear. It was a lot. It was a lot to deal with. So I do miss him in some ways, but in a lot of ways, no, I do not. This poem's called Mother Nature by request for my mom. And then we'll get into some more, I don't know. I kind of feel like let's get nasty and do some nasty rap. But after this. Don't it always seem to go? I rap. Don't it always seem to go? I rap. Don't it always seem to go? That you don't know what you got till it's. I want to sing to the birds just to pay them back. I want to glow in the dark so the moon and the stars can have a night off. I want to go underwater and windmill my arms and thrash my legs so weary currents can rest and I'll ripple the surface myself. I want to wrap my arms around tree trunk bases and shake to give the tired wind a break. And I'm not much of a tree hugger, we all know that, but god damn. I bet Mother Nature could use a day off. Let me pack a bowl of carbon to exhale the morning mist. Let me pluck the hair from my own head, weave it into spider webs, and use the bits that I've got left for makeshift birds' nests. See, we owe you, Mother Nature. It's probably time we repaid our debts. Joni Mitchell said it best. She put it all in context. She said, we've paved paradise. Put up a parking lot. Humanity's disgusting erections. Brick buildings that break the line of your beautiful horizon. Sit back, relax, and let me raise the sun for you. If only just this once. Serve Father Time divorce papers. Stop the world and I'll melt with you like modern English. Break the fingers of freewheeling clock hands. Let us linger in this moment and let time stand still. It's the least I can do because god damn, I bet Mother Nature could use a day off. We've given her a makeover. She looks like shit. So let me go underground and I'll push the grass up from the roots myself. Hurl comets across the night sky myself. Build mountains stone by stone by myself. I'll walk your fault line. I'll stomp your Morse code message of mercy. Rattle Richter scales and make sure everyone sees your earthquake whimpers for the pleas for help they really are. It's the least I can do because god damn. I bet Mother Nature could use a day off. Don't it always seem to go? I rap. Don't it always seem to go? I rap. Don't it always seem to go? That you don't know what you got till it's. Mother Nature. sip, sip, everybody.
Sip, sip, sip.
It's always so strange sitting here by myself. No idea what I sound like. I don't know about anything. What I do know is that this will become my 500th video, and at 47 minutes so far, I feel like the edited YouTube version is going to be about a 7-minute video, because there are 40 minutes of nonsenses. Let's do this. You may remember this one. From way, way back in the day.
You know, you should know that, as I stand here a bit messed up, I commence to make you.
We commence to make you.
Jump. The easy makes you.
Jump.
The DR makes you. Crisscross will make you. Don't try to compare me to another bad little fat MPOE. I'm fucking bad. I give you something that you never had. I make you jump, jump, wiggle and shake your rump. Cause I be kicking at the chest and make you wanna
jump.
How high, real high, I'm just so fly. Young, lovable, huggable type of guy. And everything is to the max with a little slack. Cause it's side out. It's wiggity, 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 whack. Come up with that, something to keep you jumping. R&B rapping, bull crap, that's what I'm dumping. Ain't nothing fake about that POE. I'm all that. So when you ask, do I rock, you believe that.
Jump.
Oh, the Weezy makes ya. And DJ Ira makes ya. Crisscross will make ya.
The
Weezy makes ya. And DJ Ira makes ya. Crisscross will make ya. I like my shit knocking. Love it when the grizzlies feel like jocking. The one and only motherfucking POE.
Yeah, you know me.
I got you jumping and thumping and fucking moving all around. Cheering in the mix and make you take a step back. Then you try to step into the mech and then you get jacked. The back, you'll be sporting the gear and that's coincidental. And like you know it, don't be claiming that it's mental. It's just one fucking new with a flow like you ain't never heard. And nothing fake and you can understand every word. And as you listen to this old school melody, the POE makes you J-U-N-P. Oh,
POE
makes you.
A DJ
Opera makes ya.
Crisscross will make ya.
The
POE
makes ya.
A DJ
Opera
makes ya.
Crisscross will
make ya.
Shit now. The formalities of this and that is that POE now. I ain't coming off whack. If all y'all suckers that don't know, check it out. Some of them try to rhyme, but they can't rhyme like this. So some of them try to rhyme, but they can't rhyme like this. So some of them try to rhyme, but they can't rhyme like this. And some of them try to rhyme, but they can't. Cause I'm the make it a make it a make it a make it a Mac Daddy. I'm the make it a make it a make it a make it a Mac. I'm the make it a make it a make it a make it a Mac Daddy. I'm the make it a make it a make it a make it a Mac. And I make you wanna
POEZ
makes ya. And DJ Opera makes ya. Crisscross will make ya. POEZ makes ya. Bill Van Cleef makes ya. Crisscross will make ya. Subtle fade out. Phil gave me the devil horns, and that's all I was in this for, really. He's excited about 500 videos. My mom says I'm starting to freeze out, but that could be on her end. Hopefully that's not the case. There was some footage before, but I thought it was kind of related to whatever song I was doing, and they were like trying to ding me for using copywritten material. And then I started to freeze up and it all went wonky. So, I don't know. Hopefully that's not the case. Let's do this. This is a medley. I like medleys. I'm a master of medleys, I think. Here is one.
Well, some people say man is made out of mud, but a poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood and skin and bone, a mind that's weak.
bag this strong, you load 16 tons. What do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, because I can't go out my soul to the company store. Oh, woman, don't you treat me so mean. You're the meanest old woman that I ever seen. I guess if you say so, wouldn't I have to pack my things and go? Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more.
Okay.
Friends.
The audio has cut out again. So, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to wrap it up shortly. I'm going to do a couple more things. We'll call this the 500th video. I'll chop it down into probably a 15 minute set. It's going to be ridiculous. The amount of things that I didn't screw up in this video are less than the amount of things that got screwed up in this video. But that's okay. Who cares? 500 videos. It's a big milestone, and I wanted to do something special for it, and this definitely qualifies as something special. F'd over at every turn. So, there's one more sponsor I'd like to shout out.
Holden Roads Coffee. Always fresh, never tired. Coffee with personality. Check out www.holdenroadscoffee.com.
I want to shout out holdenroadscoffee.com. It's always fresh, never tired coffee with personality, and you should definitely check it out. It's my favorite coffee. We bought a new coffee maker just to enjoy it, and it was well worth it, and it was phenomenal. He also happens to be my YouTube sponsor, and he also happens to be the king of Me and the Boys Wrestling, which is a digital wrestling podcast that happens every Thursday right here on YouTube, or if you're on Facebook, you'll find the links. So check it out, Thursday. Tomorrow's episode should be good. I guess that you'll be watching this in the future, maybe, so it won't be tomorrow. The 25th, May 25th's episode is probably good. Bayclash, though, is going to happen on, I believe, June 1st. That's not this Thursday, not tomorrow, but next Thursday.
Thursday, June 1st, Me and the Boys Wrestling presents Bayclash, a You're Fired match between Sonic the Hedgehog and The Mask. Daredevil takes on Tebow. Ricky Bang Bang McMaster takes on Swish Styles. Dr. Volcano takes on Riggs in a 12K title match. Ginger Snaps versus Mad Moxie in a QLLW title match. A five-way table match with too many guys to name. Gingy Forever takes on Gingy Classic. War Games ensues as the King's Court takes on the GCW. The LWO take on Bruce Dash for the tag titles. King Holden versus Murs Royalty rules for the QLW title, and the Me and the Boys title is on the line. Brent versus the Stroop Thursday, June 1st. Me and the Boys presents Bayclash.
And it's going to be a good time. Another thing I wanted to do, I want to do this one piece and dedicate it to my friend Knowledge Gonzalez, who passed 2 weeks ago-ish. And this was one of his favorites. And normally when people choose a favorite of mine, it's something sentimental or meaningful to them. Knowledge like this piece because it's nasty. And that's just the kind of fellow that he was. I can say that if every father out there was half the father that that man was, the world would be a better place. So this is for Knowledge Gonzalez.
I came tonight to thrill. I got a mic to kill. I can't fight my will to just recite and spill so tight. It's like I got gills and you gotta pay me, sucker, because I'm like bills. And you gotta at least recognize the skill. I spin syllables inside you like a cordless drill and change up my bit quick. Let's get ill like Jack and Jill. Now it's all downhill. Cemented and demented like a signpost and pavement. Lamented forever like a monument for the depraved and the insane and the fueled by rage. And anybody with a problem they can't assuage. So I stain you with anger like Doritos stain your fingers. Only put myself in danger if I just let it linger. It's infectious and contagious. I go off in rants and rages. Throw disease at you from stages, yo. It's outrageous. And this war that I've been waging's gotten way too big to gauge in. That's why this hatred sprays in every word I say. Fucking toxic methane spreading through these lines. Polluted revolution in an age of green times. I redefine unrefined intertwined lines to make rhymes that blow minds. Fuck. You didn't see the signs? Sometimes they pull my plug just for being too offensive, and I guess it gets infectious when I'm spreading my depression. I'm guessing it's not precious when it's hate I'm expressing, stress and negative straight like a backwards lesson. I'm blessed with a superpower. I'm not afraid to abuse it. Like God gave me a gift, but Satan taught me how to use it. No excuses. I get on this mic, just lose it. I'm here to prove I'm God's gift of music. I'm Kevorkian with no fucking patience left. Like Cam Persia, you know I'm intense with a 2 cents intended only for the less dense. You don't know what's coming out of my mouth. I'm like suspense. The pressure builds and now it's time to vent. You know the best defense? Fucking good offense. So would it really be such a shame to see just a little bit more tragedy? It's like blasphemy is a blast for me. So I dip my brush in catastrophe. Another planet is a canvas. It's my masterpiece. And I'm that feeling you get when you've lost your keys. They opened up Pandora's box, out pop me. P-O-E, just a synonym for calamity. See, I get on this microphone just to spread insanity. So grab a ticket to my show while I ruin humanity. You think I want to pay off? You're fucking way off. I'm just here to instill fear and spread chaos with anarchistic linguistics upon the microphone. Pessimistic and sadistic when I'm bringing it home. My antagonistic characteristics show through as I give your groin a swift kick. If you're not down, you can give my balls a good lick. I'm taking over this whole planet because it makes me sick. That is called Something Offensive and Clever. Like, that's the title. It's not that I've forgotten the title, but know that it was Something Offensive and Clever. That was the title. So I was with Knowledge Gonzalez. I believe we were in... it would have been either Saskatoon or Montreal. And I'm pretty sure it was Saskatoon. And I went to Nationals as an alternate because the team that I was on, I couldn't work with them. Couldn't work with those fucking people. I'm just kidding. It wasn't that sort of a situation. I mean, it was, but it wasn't going to work out. It wasn't going to be for the best. So if I was going to go, there was an opportunity to go as an alternate. And I went and I participated in the alternate slam. And I won that year and I got to do a poem on final stage. And I got to encore at the end of the alternate slam. And I asked the crowd, I said, do you guys want to hear a song or do you guys want to hear me rap? And the whole crowd was like, apparently. I was lost in the moment. I knew what I was doing either way. But apparently, the whole crowd was like, we want to hear you sing a song. And I was like, okay, I'm going to rap. And I did that piece that you just heard. And later on in the night, I was talking to Knowledge Gonzalez. And he's like, man, you're the fucking best. I can't believe you did that shit. You just ignored what everyone wanted and did just this nasty rap song at the Nationals of a Poetry Festival. And like... I don't know, man. He was just a real dude. He's just a real dude, and that's incredibly rare, especially in the slam poetry community. He's going to be sorely, sorely missed. And wherever he is, I hope he's cool. He's looking down at all of us, you know, weeping and getting emotional, and he's calling us all pussies. I feel like that's a truth. Friends, I'm going to do one more piece, and then I'm going to wrap this up. I keep reaching for the mouse to do songs, not real, you know, completely forgetting that the audio is crapping out on me. So, this one makes sense. Let's do this. This is called Blood.
would you say if I said that I was leaving? What would you say if I told you I was done? What would you say if I said that I'm done bleeding? What would you say if this song was my last one?
Sometimes these crimson poems taste like copper when they gush past my lips. But I just keep spilling and spitting and succumbing to blood that just won't clot or quit. There's no retreat in me. Just pints of pure, painful poetry pumping proudly through these hardened arteries. I'm a heart attack waiting to happen, but I'm an art attack in the process of happening. Like, get this front row a drop cloth because I'm spilling guts up here like chainsaw death in B-horror movies, and I'm just wondering if I'll ever break the dam of Band-Aid solutions and finally bleed out. Or if I'll ever get the stitches I need to finally shut my fucking mouth. Stepping on stage completed the Hellraiser puzzle box and opened up the door to a masochistic paradise where barbed wire metaphors and sawed-off similes become the tweed jacket and leather patches on a professor giving a lecture on how to fucking bleed. But when is it enough? I feel like I've gone 7.5 pints. You gave me my orange juice and my cookie, but I still think I might fall down. I'm lightheaded. I'm heavy-hearted. I can't be positive. I'm too A-negative. And I'm just playing in my own blood. Maybe it's time we break out the bandages. Maybe for my own good, I should give these wounds a chance to heal. Let them scab and scar and sing the stories of my skin with a respectable subtlety, because this is never going to heal if I don't stop picking. This is never going to heal if I don't stop picking. This is never going to heal.
What would you say if I said that I was leaving? What would you say if I told you I was done? What would you say if I said that I'm done bleeding? What would you say if this song was my last one?
And it is. Friends, thank you so much for all your likes, shares, views, everything over the course of the 500 videos. To everybody that's invested and put some time into me and the boys wrestling, whether it's as a character, as a viewer, as a somebody providing input, you guys know who you are. I appreciate it so much. From all the talking to myself videos, the memes I like, all the songs, all the poems, all the different things, Dr. Volcano's Cabinet of Carnage, just all of it over the last little bit. I appreciate it so much. And I look forward to continuing on this path. And I guess the next big milestone, 750. I'll see you at 750. That feels like a long time. We'll see each other before then. Friends, take care of yourselves. Enjoy the sun today. I love you. Bye. Even that. Can't even end correctly.